oil control room operations. Just like in air traffic control systems, there's a lot going on in the control rooms. And this class talks about the functions, starting from nominations, scheduling, dispatching, controlling, and reporting. Gives you insight into the inner workings of control room operations, and also includes a couple of videos, one of a simulated emergency response. Now here's a clip from oil pipeline control room operations. We talked about batching. Now here are some cut strategies. So we have blue and we have yellow, two products, and we're going from left to right. And so in the middle we have interface, which I've colored green. So one way to do it is to cut product one clean. In other words, when the interface comes up, you start putting the interface into a transmix tank, or you run it in with product two. So quintessential example here, if we have in front product one is premium gasoline and product two is mid-grade gasoline, we might take the entire interface into the mid-grade. Or we might cut at the middle of the interface there. Again, if you take the premium and mid-grade, perhaps there's enough spec room in the premium to put half of the interface in there and put the other half into the mid-grade. Don't know, we have to keep up with that. And then finally, we can cut it clean, putting transmix into a transmix tank. So various different oil interface cut strategies. One more batching example, and then we'll go on to the next topic. So here we have a line and we have an intermediate delivery point. We have four tanks in here. We have an oil manifold and a gas manifold. I probably should have labeled this distillate and gasoline, but we've got this manifold built up so we can use any of these tanks with either of the headers. We can either use them in oil service or gasoline service, depending on what we want. So in this case, we've got two that are in gasoline service, they're blue, and the two in distillate service, they are red. You can see we're coming in. If we look on the left, we have an outstation detector, perhaps a gravitometer, perhaps a color meter, perhaps both. And so it knows, it tells us when the line fill goes past there, or I should say, excuse me, when the interface goes past there. And we know the distance between the outstation and the in-station detector, so we know when it's going to arrive in the in station. So we're keeping track of this interface to then determine when we're going to deliver in. In the old days, we would always do these manually and somebody was out there sampling to make sure we got it right. As technology is moving along, most of these cuts are done by the equipment themselves in advance or downloaded in advance. As long as things are operating the way they're supposed to, everything just triggers and goes along. You'll have to know with your own SCADA system whether that's the case or not. Varies by applications, varies by SCADA systems. The interface is detected as gravity or color. We have a known line pack volumes are used to time the interface arrivals. I hope you enjoyed that clip. If you want to know more about this or any other lesson, please contact me at tom@pipelineknowledge.com or call me at the phone number. And if you like this little clip, please click on the subscribe button and you'll get notified when more tutorials and more clips are posted on YouTube.